These aren't the only things hidden in the nooks and crannies of Key House. The adaptation of the beloved comic is packed with Easter eggs, so hold tight as we walk deeper into Locke and Key's secrets that are specific to the production. Scott idolizes the special effects makeup artist Tom Savini, who in real life has worked on films like Dawn of the Dead, Friday the 13th, and the Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2. Savini's 73 years old now, and a busy man, but Savini found time to have a cameo on the show as the hardware shop owner Bodhi visits in episode 2. Your eagle eyes might have noticed that when Bodhi peers into the Key House's ancient well, the ceiling is shaped like the Echo Key. The bucket forms the stem of the key, while the wooden roof boards match the design clearly seen in the opening credits. Pause and zoom into Rendell's old yearbook in episode 3, and you'll see quotes that each of the old keepers chose. These aren't just throwaway lines, but carefully crafted insights into their stories. Ellie's, for example, reads, "Keep love in your heart. A love without it is like a sunless garden where the flowers are dead." And it's a quote by Oscar Wilde. It's a knowing nod to the flame she keeps burning for Lucas years after the tragedy that ripped the old keepers apart. Meanwhile, Erin Voss chose a quote by Mother Teresa, Rendell Locke, one by Peter Pan author J.M. Barrie, Jeff Ellis quoted Muhammad Ali, Lucas Metallica, and Mark chose Darth Vader. Speaking of previous generations, Bodhi's book that chronicles the history of Matheson hints at the identities of the original Locks. A passage glimpsed in its pages reads, "During the Revolutionary War, the Locks supplied the colonial army with artillery forged on the Key House grounds." Clearly, their ancestors were blacksmiths who not only made bullets for revolutionaries, but found a way to turn the whispering iron that shoots out the Omega Door into the magical keys. Oh, and in episode 5, Bodhi even finds an old blacksmith hammer that he brings to school to defend himself against Dodge. Gabriel Rodriguez and Joe Hill, the creators of the comics, drew themselves into the final volume of the Locke and Key series as paramedics. So when it came to making the first season of the Netflix series, the creators of the show offered them the same cameo. The circumstances aren't exactly the same, but both cameos see Hill and Rodriguez dressed as paramedics, though Hill has since grown a beard. That's a roundup of some of the most interesting Easter eggs from the first season of Locke and Key. For more content diving behind the scenes of your favourite Netflix shows, keep checking back on Netflix UK.